This conference will now be recorded.
So I just connected on Excel. I'm going into the sheet. So we were talking about this mark properties, okay, like the settings. We were talking about this color yesterday. We'll continue with the other properties now, okay? So I will just make a simple chart. I'll go with the bar chart for now. Okay, this size thing, right? If you do not have anything on the size, if you click this icon, you will see like this, like a slider where you can change the size of the bar. So I can have it as thin as possible, or I can have like as thick as possible. Okay, so this small icon is like a midpoint, so it's better that you leave it here. So travel itself is takes that, but still you can change the size of the bar however you want it. Okay, and in this size you can put a dimension there, but it doesn't really give meaning. So let me show you what happens when I put a region in the size. So when I put region, it is just giving the size alphabetically. So for C is giving small, for W is giving big. So it's has no meaning. So we will not really put a dimension to size. Okay,
Meaning,
but yeah, so we could put a measure. So maybe to put sales, right? For a bar chart, size is not really required, but for this chart, right? The size is the thing. Okay, maybe when I show the chart, you will see it better. But to help you understand, usually in the size we'll have some measure. In this chart, what is happening is that based on the sales value, the size is changing. Okay, or I can have some other measure also. Let me put profit to size. So it is changing the size of the bar by the profit value. So let's say the profit, let's say the thinner the bar. If it is more profit, thicker the bar. Okay, maybe I'll show another example. Just give me a second. Just give me a second, it looks like something's wrong with my computer, just got hanged.
So the length gives the sum of sales, and the width gives of give, width of this horizontal bar gives the profit,
Profit.
right?
Yeah, but we will not really try the like the style for the bar chart. But if you remember the map yesterday we were seeing, right? Map ka circle size we were giving with something, so that circle size was in the size thing, size setting. Okay. Let me close the Tableau. Something's wrong. Let me reopen Tableau. Be online or come. Okay, I think it came back. Yeah, we are good. So here, right? Okay, yeah. So here, what I was trying to show is that this subcategory might be a better example. Okay, this right. If you see this bar machines, if you see tables. In terms of sales, they are high, but in terms of profit, they are low. That's why it's very thin in nature. Actually, they are negative, actually. That's why it's very thin. Okay. So this could maybe, let's say, I'll just show you this chart for now. If this chart, right? This chart, let me remove this. So this chart, if I have my sales in the size, based on the size sales value only, it is sizing. I can have my profit in color, maybe. So I haven't touched this chart. But to show you or to help you understand is that you can see profit is in color, sales is in size, and the subcategory is in label. So that is about the size. You clear the size, right? Yeah. Shall I move
Play
on to?
out.
So moving on.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Great. So moving on to the label, right? Let me go to the bar chart itself. It's actually a good spot to explain things. So this label, right? Label is nothing but the text what you see here. So here, if I check this button, if you remember, it's like a shortcut to turn on and turn off. Like, give it a second, it's loading. So you can turn on and turn off the labels. Okay. So if you want to customize it, so yeah, click here. Come back to this label. If you see also, you can see that option like on off button, show mark label, show like it's like on off switch. Okay, if you want to change the font, if you want to change the alignment, you can change it here. Okay, and this option, right, this will not work out if you click just this, but if I put the sales into the label, Okay, so labels is here. When you drop something into the label, then this option will come, this text thing. So if you click this three dot, you can type it here. You can say, I want a dollar symbol here. Like there's something like that. You can kind of edit it. You can do the changes here itself, the outside itself. But still, if you want to do some font coloring, you want to change the size, you want to add some, you want to add some text there, some default text, or you want to have multiple things, but in the side by side. So let me show you. I'm adding profit here, but profit is coming next to the other, like sales first and then the profit, but I want to have it side by side. So I'll just go here, I'll edit it and I'll do like this. Okay, so all I did is nothing but click on the label, click on the text, the three dots, you'll get this edit label window. You can have like this, and as soon as you give okay, you could see that sales and profit is coming side by side instead of having one below the other. Okay.
It seems like the value is of one value.
Yeah. It's confusing.
It's not of two values.
Yeah, maybe you can have like a like this something, is it space or some the separator, so that you'll understand that they are two different values. Fine.
But one value can, is it possible to display one value on the bar itself?
You can
instead
have
everything here like this.
Yeah, I get your point. You can do some tricks. I'm just thinking.
Yeah.
You could do some tricks, but directly to answer your question, maybe I can show you the trick later. But directly, you can have the values, but still, everything together only will come, like on the bar, on the center, on the left side, on the right side. That alignment will be changed. But answering your question, to have like one value inside, one value outside, then we have to trick it or we have to change something. Okay. Fine, got it? Yeah. No direct way, but you can do some tricks to it.
Yeah.
I can help you to help that later, but make sure to remind me a little later when we maybe when we are close to the charts, right? Just remind me that the same thing, the chart with one value inside, one value outside. I think I can help you on that. Okay. Yeah. And I'll remove the profit for now to avoid the confusion. I'll click the three dots and say reset. So it'll come back to how it was before. Okay. Here, right, there are a few options. Marks to label, all selected, min max, highlighted. Okay. So in this chart, if you see, everything is shown, okay, because the space is fine, everything is perfect. But let's try some other chart. Let's try this chart for now. So if you see here, right, it is showing for only few charts. You see, it's not showing for everything because you have to remember, right, Tableau's way of texting, right, labeling is nothing but it will not change dynamically for dynamic things. The size will be same, unique. Okay, you can try reducing the font size to see if you can do anything, 8, or you can even type 7 and give enter. So it is coming for few, but still not for these dots. Okay, so what you can do is that this option, can you see this option here? Allow labels to overlap other marks.
Yes.
If you check this, Tableau will force to show that labels. In this case, it is fine. It's not looking so awkward, but in some places, right, if it is too many things, maybe let me show you this. Let me show you this product name. See this? The chart is changing. Actually, there is a chart. Let me hide this thing. So this is the chart. Okay. So but when I check this option, show labels to allow labels to overlap other marks. So what is happening is that it's showing all the, it is forcing Tableau to show all the labels. That labels itself is kind of hiding the chart. So which we will not really do. Okay. So this is only if it is a very small list, we will use that. If it is too many, we'll avoid that. So we will allow Tableau to show the labels. We will not really force it unless it's a small thing. Okay. Like this, it's fine. Like this example, the subcategory here, fasteners is that label kind of touching the art, but still it's kind of okay. You can kind of use it with you. Yeah, and this option, what I was trying to show is that this mark labels, if you click on the selected, so label will not come. Only when they click on that, you'll see the label. Mm-hmm. So when they click on that, you'll see the label. Okay. So selected and highlighted are kind of same here. We will see about little highlighting little later, but for now I want you to assume both are same, selected and highlighted. So when you click, it's getting highlighted and it will show only when you
Okay.
highlight the particular circle, unless and until you will not see the labels there. Okay. And this last option, min max. So when I click on min max, it will show only the minimum maximum. You can pick what you want. I want based on the sales value. So based on sales value, it is showing the text. So phones and fastener are the min and max in our data set. Okay. Maybe if I want the sales value to be shown, I'll put that here instead of subcategory. So you will see the value. So it's just 330007 and here it's something like 3024. That's the min and max in your view. Okay, so instead of showing all the labels, you can change this whether you want all, whether you want selected, highlighted, or min and max. Okay. It's min and max, we usually use it when it's a line chart, maybe. Line chart or bar chart, where if it has like too many bars, you want to show at least something. Min and max should be fine. But everywhere we try to use this all only. Rarely we'll use the other three. Okay. And we will allow Tableau to show it. Mostly we will not touch this option unless and until if you are very sure that it's not going to change. So I am very sure on this data set because this is a static data, point number one. Point number two, this is just like missing only for view and it is not really changing the view if it comes. It's not really affecting others. So in that case, I'll turn this on, else I will avoid myself on clicking this option. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, moving on. Next thing is called as detail. Okay, so in detail, when you click, there is no option. It's just like detail thing. Okay, so for detail, what you can do is that you can add a measure or dimension. Okay, okay. Let's use the same example itself, or let me try a simple example. Let me put region and color. Let me try like this. Okay, so let me remove the labels for now. Or maybe let me put the region in the label. Let me show you like this. So here, if you see, it is like three circles. When let's say I am putting a segment into detail, okay, so the circles has increased. It's like what I'm saying is that Tableau to consider both region and segment the view, but the segment is not affecting anything. The coloring is by region, the label is by region, but the segment is causing us to have like multiple bubbles. So you could see the three circles, three blue circles, which is for central, but one is for consumer, one is for corporate, one is for home office. So to increase my level of detail of the chart, and I can put the something into my detail. Okay. So adding something to detail will not really affect the color, affect the region or of the sizes by the sales value only, but what adding segment will kind of split the chart, and based on that only the sales value will be, and that's how it's gonna size. Okay, maybe I'll show another example. If we remove the segment, I'll make it a bar chart. Let me show you that it's a bar chart. Okay, so it is at the region level. Let it be like this, or if you want, I can even put region to color like this. Okay, it's showing the regional sales. When I put segment to detail, it's not changing the chart, if you see. Okay, the chart feels same, but if you have your mouse over those, you could see it's kind of in different pieces. Can you feel it? It's like a stacked bar chart without the coloring, like it's like a pieces there. Like I'm just clicking to show you. Can you feel it? So it's a bar chart at a region sales level, but as I put the segment into detail, the detail of the bar chart has increased, so you are seeing multiple pieces in one bar.
Yes.
Yeah. So this is what this detail. If you add some metric to detail, it's not going to really affect anything. Maybe it'll show that value in the tool. Sorry, I missed you. What was that?
But if I want to show see the segments in different colors, means what?
Then you have to put the segment in the color. That will become your stacked bar chart, which is you're not putting into detail, but you're putting into color. That's the difference.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And putting measure into detail, it just will show in the tooltip. That's it. So, adding measure will not really affect the chart, but adding a measure to the retail will increase the level of detail of your chart. Okay, so to help you understand better, if you add here also your dimension, right? If you put in color, size, label, okay, these three things, it will also indirectly being added to detail. Okay, that is also changing the level of detail of your chart, but adding something to detail will not affect the color, size, or label. Okay, it's just for view purpose. Let's say I'll put it again. It's equal to this thing. The chart you see is just at the that's a region level, but the detail of the chart is at a segment level. So regional segment, you have to kind of combine both. Okay. Fine.
Okay.
Shall we move on?
Fine, fine.
Yeah. Okay. So next thing, right? Next thing is this tooltip. So when I click on this tooltip, I can edit it. So let's say I want the region in a very big format. I'm deleting this. I'm selecting it. I'm making it bigger. So it's nothing but to help you format the region. So you can pretty much for change everything, the change the names, change the colors, alignment. So maybe it will show like this. Instead of showing regions this value, I remove the word region and making that region value is bigger. So central like this. And if you move down, it shows west and it shows the value, something like that. You can just edit the tooltip however you want. Okay.
Okay.
And even in tooltip also, you can add a dimensional measure. Okay. So remember, adding a dimension to tooltip will not do anything. It's just going to convert something to an attribute. So I'll talk about attribute now. So maybe I'll remove the segment. So let me put the segment itself. So if I put the segment into attribute, I mean to the tooltip, can you see this establishing ATTR segment? Earlier we did not see like this, but right now it is saying as ATTR. Can you see this?
Yes.
Yeah, it means that Tableau is converting the dimension to attribute.
Yes.
Yeah. By default, in the tooltip, if you drag and drop a dimension, it will convert to a attribute that you cannot avoid. Okay. So what happens when you add as attribute is that it will not change the value of anything. So if you see, right, it is not showing anything at all. Wait, let me reset this. I think I changed the tooltip, so it's not coming properly. So I reset the tooltip. So if you see, it is showing as segment star. Okay. So adding your segment to the tooltip has made that particular dimension into attribute. It converted, and also it is not really increasing the level of detail of your chart. It is showing a star, which means on that particular region there are multiple segment, so you will see a star. Okay, if there was only one segment, you will see the value. So attribute is nothing but if you have like one value, it will show the value, else it will show a star. So let me show you another example. So let's put subcategory. Subcategory, I'll just drag and drop category and put to tooltip. So it will convert to attribute. But as I have played with this data, I know that one subcategory will have only one category, like a parent, you can assume. So one subcategory will have like one parent. Okay. So when I have the mouse here, though it is an attribute, it is showing the value because there is only one value for that particular attribute, so it will show the value. But if I put the region into tooltip, so each subcategory is sold in multiple region, so it has multiple values in that attribute, so it is showing a star. So both category and region are attribute, both are attribute, but category attribute has only one value, but region attribute has multiple value. That's why there's a small difference in the view you could see. You got it? So technically, we will not really put some dimension into a tooltip, but if you put, it converts to attribute, and then the attribute will react like this. So this is how the attribute works. Okay. So we rarely put something into the tooltip, some dimension in the tooltip, but if you add, this is what is going to happen. So that's why I'm showing you. Okay.
Okay.
If you really want something, let's say you really want category, or you really want region, then don't add to tooltip, but add to as a column, add to detail, add to color. Well, maybe you can place anywhere else except the tooltip. Okay. Then you will see your chart kind of divided based on the region or colored by the region, which would really be helpful. So avoid adding the dimension to the tooltip. Okay. Unless if it's going to be like one value or attributes,
okay.
It's going to come to attribute. So let's say it's like extra information, but you are very sure that, but that particular dimension will have like one value, which is as I was showing you, right? subcategory has only one category. That I was very sure. In that case, I'll put, but still, instead of putting that, I'll put to detail, so it will be better also. Yeah. And measure you can put into tooltip. That has no effect. So putting measure here will show the measure in your tooltip. So I put it profit. You can have n number of measure there. It's not a problem. Yeah. Just to show extra information, you could do like this. Okay. And you clear this five icons, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so you could kind of match it. So this is a detail. This is tooltip. I think color size.
Rajiv,
tell me.
So you are sharing me the notes and all, right? WebEx recordings, when can you share?
I think they'll be sending at the very end of the class, maybe. Okay, I'm kind of saving it on my machine.
Uh-huh.
So I'll just upload it and I think they'll be doing it at the very end. And notes we didn't type, right? We didn't type anything. If I type, I'm sending it and that. So for today, I thought I'm just explaining you this. So we didn't type any notes for today or yesterday.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll continue, right?
Yes, yes, you can.
So you are clear the five icons, right? So there will be sixth icon then and there, okay? So for when it comes, if you ask me, it comes when you select shape, okay? So
okay.
When you select shape, right, maybe this is not the right chart, maybe shape you might be using on this scatter plot. We are reducing the scatter plot, but just to, for the sake of explaining the sixth icon, I'm just showing you this. This shape, right, you can click on the shape, you can edit it. Or if you want, you can even put the region to shape. It's like, just like coloring, it will show different shapes for different region values. You can see the legend also here, right? Something like this, okay? And shape, this is the sixth icon. You can change the icons. Let's say I want to look at the here. If you have your own shapes also, you can bring it. So let's say you have your symbols like this. You can pick this. I want central like this. I want east like this, south like this. You can just pick the different symbols if you want. Okay. And other values, if you ask me, I think you'll see it here on the line chart. On the line chart, you'll see a path. Okay. So this is not line chart. Usually, we will show it for only a date.
Yeah.
This is not related date here. So I'll remove it. For the sake of example, let me try some date. Let me go with some other date. Let me change the orientation. Yeah, I'll have it at quarter level. Remember, when you drag and drop a date, it will come by default at a year level. Okay, so you have to pick what level you want. I will talk about this again later. But what exactly is this? If you ask me, simple. This is like a split of
by default, which level?
Year.
Okay. Yeah. I tried once.
Yeah, it will go here. You can right click and pick
date column. It is displaying only here.
Yeah, you have to pick either of them. Whether you want at a split, this is like a split, this is like a truncate. We will see the formula later. Yeah, so usually I will like to go with like month or whatever you want. Okay, so here, right, path is nothing but using path. What you can do is that they have recently given an option like this. When you click, if you are using latest version of Tableau, you will see this option. When you click on path, you can select like this.
Hello.
So you want like a stepped chart. Can you hear me? Hello?
Your voice is breaking actually.
No, is it better now?
Hello?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So if you're using the latest version of Tableau, when you click on the path, you will see like this. So this is our regular line chart. Mm-hmm. This thing they call a step chart, okay? So it will feel like a steps, like going up and down. And this is like a line, just line, like a bar, but without a full complete bar, just the top thing they are just highlighting. It's like they call it jump plot, jump line, okay? So you can change that. And also, let me go back to this line chart. If you, this path is nothing but you can make Tableau to change the path, which we'll not really do, but just for you to show, I'll just put the sales to path. So based on sales value is drawing the line instead of drawing in terms of the date, right? Instead of drawing in date wise, it is drawing in terms of the sales wise, which is not really helpful. Okay, so if you want to draw some line and you know how it has to draw like a path, right? Then you can put something to path, which I never really use. Mm-hmm. I'm just showing you like how it works with. Okay. And do you see? Okay. In pie chart also, you'll see the sixth icon. That's something to note. Maybe let me try a simple example. This. Let me go to pie chart. Let me name the size. Size here is not meaningful. So this angle is nothing but if you click, nothing's going to happen. But only if you have that particular measure in the angle, that's how it's going to give the size. So I'll remove from the angle, see what happened. It is giving for each region, it's giving equal space. But when I put some sales or some profit to angle, okay, that price is changing. So this sixth icon comes mm-hmm. for pie chart also. Okay.
Okay.
And these are the different types.
So what is the...
Yeah, go ahead.
What is the difference of creating pie charts from mass or show me icon?
Okay, yeah. So what's the difference if you ask me, right? If you click on show me option, Tableau will automatically move things. So yes, for the nothing should be here, but it should be here. So Tableau will automatically move. But let's say I'm in a bar chart, I'm clicking on pie mm-hmm. chart. Tableau will not really move these things. Mm-hmm. It will just change the mark to a pie chart. You feel it is a circle because nothing is here. Nothing is there in color, nothing is there in angle. So it is just showing us a circle. Okay, but if you click on show me, Tableau will automatically set what needs to be there in the right place. Okay. So if you change something in marks, it will change only the mark. It will not change the position of your pills. So let's say I make it bar, it shows bar. If I make it line, it will make it line. But this line chart Tableau will not allow here because like we'll see about line chart, but like Tableau will allow line chart only if that's a date. This is like a you're forcing Tableau to change some mark type. This is like Tableau's changing the mark type or changing everything based on what it needs. So if you, even if you click this, Tableau is changing it. So when I click this, Tableau is changing this mark thing every time, but it is changing the position of the pills also. But when you change here, it will not change itself. So when I click bar, right, it's not a proper bar chart. So for bar chart, things should be here. So I have to either drag and drop manually or I can click things on the my show me option, show me charts. Got it? So this is like only one part of the chart. This is like a complete chart. That's what I'm saying. This is just this one piece will be changed. Nothing, not the dimension measure or not the this mark shelf. Nothing will change or when you change this. But when you change this, everything changes. It changes the position of the pills.
Okay.
Yeah. And this thing, right? So lastly, I just want to talk about this here. So this, when you change, right? So I was also trying to talk about the same when you were asking about the show me. So when you change this, it will just change the mark type. So if you click on shape, it will become shape. If you click on text, it will become text. So maybe on a like this, we'll not have a text. So when it comes to text, we'll not have anything on the columns, but we'll have it on the text here. So here it will be, you can have something here, but not a measure. You can have something like segment here maybe. So when it comes to table, we'll not really have our measure value in this, the column shelf or row shelf, but we'll have in the text. So which you can actually click here, so Tableau will automatically change it, but you also can remember. So each combination of chart, I mean, each chart needs each combination of the marks, colors, the column shelf, the row shelf. So basically the chart is nothing but combination of these things, this mark shelf, this properties, this these things, okay, which I will advise you to make use of the show me option itself and then customize from that instead of we trying to study or trying to figure it out ourselves. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. We'll stop here. We'll continue tomorrow. Okay.
Sure. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. See you tomorrow.